NPR current affairs main discussion. Today we will discuss economic affairs question number 4, which is India has signed more than 40 trade agreements till date. What is political economic significance of these agreements? Critically analyze with reference to recent trends in FTAs.
Okay. So what should be the context of this question?
Sir, firstly we need to understand what is a free trade agreement.
Okay.
A free trade agreement is a preferential agreement in which all member states agree to reduce their tariff barriers in regard to trade between amongst them.
Okay.
But when it comes to trade with non-members,
mm-hmm.
they can follow their own tariff regulations.
Okay.
This is the most basic form of economic integration, followed mm-hmm. by custom union, common market,
mm-hmm.
and then monetary union or political union.
So, like, we want to give a core answer in one line. So, what should be the political economic significance of this trade agreements?
All trade agreements should have as their basic objective, number one, welfare
mm-hmm.
of the nation in mm-hmm. terms of per capita income
mm-hmm.
or GDP,
mm-hmm.
and number two, it should foster greater, better relations with other world nations.
Okay. So we can say that with respect to developed countries, we can build our soft power,
mm-hmm.
and with respect to developing countries, we can build our market access, right?
So if we specify karna hai, political and economic framework, mm-hmm. so now we separate it. First, let's political framework. What can we discuss in political framework? Mein kya sakti hai?
So political framework, we have most of India's trade agreements today.
Mm-hmm.
They have been focusing upon Asia.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. So geographical proximity was the major concern back in the day. Along with this geographical proximity, you know, NAM was one of the critical factors back in the 1960s ke time pe humara zyada momentum usi ke time pe tha, aur isi time pe humara trade agreements ban bhi rahe the, like India-Africa trade agreement that happened in 1960s, right? So ek core context to wahan se aata. Dusra, lekin aaj ki date mein post Cold War world abhi thoda shift hai, NAM ke andar bhi humara shift hai aur political tie-ups better ho rahe, like Indo-US nuclear agreement happened, you know. So sectorally we have improved. So now political proximities are the better determining factors for any kind of trade agreements. Like TPP is the one of the case in scenario. Yeah. So there is no geographical proximity as it is, but because of political proximity, the quantitative and qualitative aspects all are matching. Therefore, these nations are moving forward with it. And you can see the case of yuan, for example.
Mm-hmm.
Previously, China used to regulate its currency, yuan, by itself, and it used to downgrade the currency for export promotion. But now, because it wanted to ally with the capitalist framework of the world economy,
mm-hmm.
it has also started, market valuation of the currency of yuan. Yes, from 2014 onwards.
Mm-hmm.
That is why IMF considered it as a part of the base currencies within the SDR, right?
Mm-hmm.
So this kind of political framework is now coming up, where both the emerging economies as well as the developed economies are capable of aligning with each other
mm-hmm.
on a more soft power initiative. And developing economies can align with developing based upon the market access initiative. And remaining are the economic frameworks also. So economic framework mein inhone abhi tak kya arrangement kiya?
Mere ko basically lagta hai ki economic framework jo hai, wo do facts ke upar move kar raha hai. Ek hai trade balance aur dusra hai welfare.
Okay.
लेकिन अगर हम थोड़ा सा इसको कैलकुलेट करें या थोड़ा सा रीसेंट डेवलपमेंट्स को देखें तो हम यहां पे देखेंगे कि जो ट्रेड बैलेंस है वो बेसिकली ट्रेड बैलेंस नहीं, वो ट्रेड इंबैलेंस है.
ओके.
जो कि टिल्ट कर रहा है किसी भी पर्टिकुलर कंट्री के लिए.
ओके.
और जो वेलफेयर है वो वेलफेयर भी डिफाइन नहीं कर सकते तुम, क्योंकि जब कोई इन्वेस्टमेंट आ रही है बेसिकली तो वेलफेयर ओरिएंटेड भी हो सकती है एंड एंटी वेलफेयर भी हो सकती है. तो बेसिकली जो इकोनॉमिक एस्पेक्ट्स है दो, वो दोनों पॉजिटिव भी हो सकते हैं, नेगेटिव भी हो सकते हैं.
एज वी हैव ऑलरेडी सीन है ना, तो जो इंडिया एफटीए एग्रीमेंट हुआ है एशियान के साथ
वो पॉजिटिव है,
वो पॉजिटिव है. जापान और कोरिया के साथ थोड़ा नेगेटिव रहा
है,
तो वो एस्पेक्ट उसमें रहेगा.
मोरओवर इफ वी सी आवर एफटीए ट्रेड विद आवर नेबरिंग नेशंस, फॉर एग्जांपल नेपाल, नेपाल इज अ वेरी स्मॉल कंट्री, तो उनके साथ हमारा ट्रेड बैलेंस हैज बीन अनफेवरेबल फॉर नेपाल, इट हैज बीन, बट विद चाइना इट हैज बीन अनफेवरेबल फॉर इंडिया.
सो व्हाट शुड बी द वे अहेड विद रिस्पेक्ट टू दिस पॉलिटिकल इकोनॉमिक सिग्निफिकेंस तो हो गया. So what should be the way ahead for free trade agreements with respect to India?
If India is to ensure that the foreign exchange earnings from free trade agreements trickle down and raise the standard of living of the people and India's reputation in Committee of World Nations, then India needs to export those commodities which have high income elasticity.
Yes. And more so industrial sector needs to be built more than service sector, because it finds a demand everywhere in the world economy. Right. Service sector ke liye demand dhoondni thodi mushkil ho jati hai. So industrial sector ko thoda push karna padega, right?
Yes.
All right. Thank you so much. Okay.